So now we're going to switch over to the brown spirits. And starting off, we have Agnesi. So Agnesi is our five-year-old brandy. And who is Agnesi? So Agnesi was an Italian woman from the 1700s, and she was a mathematician and a theologian. She was the first woman to be appointed as a professor at a university, and she was the first woman to publish a mathematical handbook. And what made her so very famous was this curve right here that goes up around her image, and that is the modern day bell curve.
So we actually source Dolcetto from Russian River Valley and then French Colombard from the Central Valley of California. And we've blended different barrels to create this five-year brandy. My background is in wine, so this is a little bit closer to my passion, just working with the different barrel types and cooperages to create a beautiful blend, a beautiful classic brandy that's very sippable. You're going to want to share it with someone you love. It's very nice.
And then we have Hypatia. So Hypatia was, she was from the 4th century, and she was a Greek woman that was living in Egypt. And she was a teacher at the University of Alexandria. And she had a lot of people that came to her classes, because what she was saying at the time was quite blasphemous. She was telling people to not necessarily believe what the Christian church is telling people to believe, but to form their own thought and then make their own conclusions. And her thinking and got people so very upset that one day they went into her classroom and took her out of the classroom and unfortunately beat her to death and burned her books. So a bit of a sad end for Hypatia, but she was very influential during her period.
So this has been a really fun project to work with Francis on. He obviously has a big hand in all of the flavors and all of the styles that go into these, and the Hypatia is no exception. So he was tinkering in his kitchen, looking for the right bitters recipe to go with his cocktails, and he came up with this style. We've refined it just a bit to really kind of bring out those flavors that he was looking for. It does contain cochineal, which is a very natural occurring. It's a beetle from Mexico. So yes, there's bugs in there.
Beetlejuice.
Not vegetarian. It's just sort of the more organic, natural way to color foods, clothing, makeup, etc. And then we've also added some Pinot Noir stems from some of our vineyards in here, just to tie into the winery side of the business as well. There's a lot of other botanicals that go into this, cassia bark, orris root. They're all very natural and very healthy for you. And this is just sort of an example of what you can do and drink in a beautiful cocktail.